Hello and welcome to a television production class. We have been talking about different aspects of television and different parts of TV camera. Today we are going to look at the practical aspect of a television camera. With me, I have a Sony XT camera. We are going to use it for our today's demonstration. Maybe I'm holding this, what we call the handle. I'm holding the camera. It is called the handle. And we say that cameras are always very delicate. You must hold them with a lot of stability, maybe to avoid incurring extra cost. So let's begin from the back of the camera. We're going to look, begin from the back, and we're going to go to the front side of the camera. So at the back here, we have the place you can be able to insert a battery, or else to input a battery of the camera. And it's a battery release. If you want to insert or to remove the battery, you have to place it inside and pull the battery upside and be able to remove the camera battery. If you want to insert the same battery, the same procedure are followed. Just make sure it is inside. And now this time around, you are not pressing it upward, but you are pressing it downward. And make sure you are able to hear that particular sound to ensure that it's properly fixed. Still, at the back of this camera, you have a place you can be able to insert SD card. Maybe you're having two SD cards, okay, or memory cards, or one. You can be able to, you have two ports, you can be able to insert the first port or the second port of the camera. So you can also close it. Then still at the back of the camera, there's a place you can be able to use for charging, or the where you are going to insert the camera charger, if you want to charge the camera. Then you have a place you can be able to insert HDMI card, and maybe you want to connect your camera to a screen or else a television screen. You are going to use SD card, the HDMI cable. You are going to insert the HDMI cable at this particular point. Then let's venture or move at the center of the camera. Now with me, let's look at this one first. This is what we call the viewfinder. The viewfinder is normally used probably when you want to save the battery of the camera. Or else you can use the viewfinder if you want to focus an image, and maybe your battery is running low of power. You are going to use the viewfinder and you're able to capture the image or your subject. Then let's move at the audio medium level, or is the audio part. This is the place you are going to set your audio, depending where you have connected your mic. You have the setting here, and the stabilizer. You can set your audio into autofocus or else into manual focus. But in most cases, professional photographers always use manual focus, depending on the setting of the event or the subject. So you can set it to autofocus, or you can set it to manual focus of the camera either way. And this one determines the mic you are using. The supplies you are going to input the microphone, and these microphones are always set at this particular audio level. And if you want to input your mic, there are two levels here. At this particular point, you are going to insert you have the first input or the input one and the input two. So you are going to input your microphone either in the first port or the second port. And once you have input the microphone, already you have inserted your microphone in these particular ports, you are going now to set your audio levels at this part. You can either increase your audio level by use of a modulation cables here, or port. You can either adjust to the right or to the left, depending on the volume or the size of the volume that the speaker is using. Maybe let's say the speaker is speaking at a very slow rate. You can increase the audio, or you can reduce the audio of that particular microphone. Then when we continue moving in front of the camera, we have the focus mode here. You can set the camera into autofocus mode here at the top, or you can set your camera into manual mode at the bottom. At the bottom of this particular camera. Or else you can press here to automatically set your camera into autofocus mode. So the camera is going to determine the light intensity, the shutter speed, or the setting of the light in your camera that you are going to use. Or else you can also set the filters here. The filters determine the intensity of light that enters the camera lenses. You can set the filter into, you can set them to off, whereby they are at zero. You can increase the lighting at one, or else you can add up to two depending on the environment of your shoot, or the environment of your shoot that were that you are capturing your images or you are capturing your subject. Then you have a place for white balancing, or else in Zumba time it is always WB. White balancing determines the intensity of the light that is you are going to regulate in your camera, and it ensures that you have balanced all the color temperature in your camera. Then you have the shutter speed. The shutter speed determines how often, or else for how long the camera lenses are going to open to the subject. You can either increase the white balancing, or else you can reduce the white balancing by the gain button. You can gain either backward, or you can gain it in the front side. Then you have the menu. The menu button is used for setting all the settings in the camera, or else all the aspects of the camera. You just press the menu setting, and you are going to come to your LCD. LCD is what you call liquid crystal display. It is movable, you can rotate it depending on where the subject is located. So once you can use the menu button to set different aspects of the camera, be it weight balancing, be it the shutter speed, be it let's say the aperture of the camera, you can use the LCD to be able to capture, to come up with the most appropriate setting that you want and to use in order to capture the perfect image. So let's move in front a bit. We have the lenses here. We have the zoom lenses and the focus lenses that are used to move either the subject, either close or far. When you are zooming in, the subject becomes wider. When you zoom out, the subject becomes smaller. You can also use the focusing lens to make sure that you get the clarity of the subject. Then you have the light regulatory mode. You can regulate either the light intensity by either increasing the light or reducing the light intensity of your camera. Then in front here have the lenses of the camera, and they must always be protected by the cap. You can either open them or you can close the lenses. When you close, you are protecting the lenses from dust or else any other substances that can be able to harm your lens. You can close it when you are not using, and when you are using, you can be able to open your lenses to capture the image or the subject of your focus. Then this other hand can use it for holding the camera. Then you have the zoom here. You can either zoom in or you can either zoom out depending on the thing that you want to communicate to your target audiences. So maybe some of you are yet to understand where you are going to sit on this particular camera. It is always here. It is written the power. You can either switch on the power or you can switch off the power, either way, depending on what you want to capture. Once you want to use the camera, it must always be on. And maybe to save the battery, if you are finished using the camera, make sure it is off. And the red button here is simply for recording your images or the subject that you want to capture or your video clip. You can either use this recording button, but still, there is the same recording button at the top of the camera. You can also use this one if you're using LCD for recording purposes. Even this recording button is also accompanied by the zoom. You can either zoom in or you can either zoom out your camera. Maybe you don't know how to set on the light, or else you are operating at a dark room or the evening time, and maybe you want to use the light. It is very easy. The light is always at the front of the camera here. You can switch on the light to increase the intensity. Yeah. Maybe at the evening hour, or else in the dark room, you can switch on the light to increase your sensitivity of the camera to the subject, or you can switch it off if indeed you have sufficient light. Still, you have the speakers here, then that normally used for capturing the audio. or else can you read the audio by use of these particular speakers of the camera. So I hope you have been able to get the basic parts of the video camera. We are still going to discuss more concerning a camera operation in these particular classes or consecutive classes we are going to hold in the future time. Thank you so much, and I hope you have been able to contextualize and understand basic parts of the television camera. You have been able to understand how to operate this particular camera, how to set basic parts of the camera, and how to protect your camera lenses by using of the camera cap. Let's meet next time at the same place. Thank you.